Ladies and gentlemen, the Iberia Progressive Party is committed to fixing our health services. And if the Iberia Health Authority is not performing as it is supposed to be performing, we will also do something about that when we are elected. My fellow constituents, and indeed my fellow Iberians, tonight I want to make it abundantly clear that the Anguilla Progressive Party is in the process of creating the most dynamic political team ever established in Anguilla. We are not building a coalition with any other group at this time, contrary to what others may be saying to us. We are building a team that is willing and ready to fight for your interests. We are on the side of the people, and we have enough candidates capable of forming the next government in Iberia. If we have to make decisions in this election, let it be known. We will come to you, the people, and we will listen to you, the people, who have elected us. Governing the affairs of this island territory is bigger than any of us, bigger than any politician. So don't be fooled by those who tell you that only some politicians can fix the problems that we have in Iberia today. Don't be fooled by them. Are any of them God? Is this a human use, God?
No!
Is this a Mr. Banks, God?
No!
Tell them that God has also given others gifts and graces, and that it is high time that people of Iberia give them an opportunity to lead as well.
Right.
Send a message to the youth of this land. Send a message to your children that they too are leaders and that they must not be afraid to pursue their dreams to be leaders. Send a message to them. We are not afraid to pursue our dreams, to be leaders in this blessed land that God has given us. We may be young, but we know that when we are elected, we will need your help. Yes, we will need our hands on deck to reposition this island for future growth and prosperity. Be assured that we will work with you, even as we work with, even as you work with us, to put and wear back on course. Ladies and gentlemen, this evening I would only hope that the current administration do not dare to use that old slogan, steering the right course again. Because we are now way off course, and we are fighting to bring us back on track. We need a change. Please do not allow them, for heaven's sake, to rearrange.
Light is out.
There are those who are asking you to give them another chance. I want you to tell them, and I want you to tell them that if they had the foresight to create laws not be lamented today over the destruction of our poor reefs. Then tell them we would not have seen the filling of the marine hole with concrete if they had had sight to protect our environment when they were in power. Tell them if they had registered some of the roads that are now deemed not public, we would not have a problem today accessing our public facilities along Angular Coast Line.
That's right.
I want to repeat, ladies and gentlemen, tell your youth that if they had registered some of the roads that are now deemed not public, we would not have a problem today accessing our own public facilities along in Willow Fort Valley. And yet, there are those who will continue to say that they love them because they tell you everything.
But say nothing.
If it wasn't for Mr. Hughes, we would not know this. Tell it for yourself. Tell it for us. Not this time. Ladies and gentlemen, what the world needs to know is that we have had enough power. What the world needs now is not talk, but action. And the Angola Progressive Party is the key to the future prosperity of this land. We live at a time when the cost of utilities is going up, when wages are coming down. Can you imagine a government who will increase civil servant salaries in the middle of a recession and then cutting them back after only 9 months?
No compassion.
Just imagine.
Weak leadership.
Just imagine if you are a woman and you are pregnant and you decide to get pregnant because you had an increase in salary. And before the child is born, after 9 months, before 9 months, that salary that you were depending upon to raise your child was cut back. What is in the world is going on?
Shame.
We are dealing with a very responsible government.
Ignorance.
Our government is planning to give back accommodation tax revenues to the flag is off. At this time, while the property tax of poor Williams is going up, we are very concerned about the number of Williams who are out of work today. And I would like to say to our government, if you are truly concerned about the number of Angolans who are out of work, then take another look at the Asians who are still on the island. Doing what Angolans could be doing. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to remind us this evening of a developing situation, and the Viceroy situation is developing just as what developed as a fly luxury resort, with many of our Angolan contractors, many of the persons who were working on that project were not paid.